Hello students, today we are going to study exercise of first lesson of general science of class 7. The name of first lesson is The Living World, Adaptation and Classification. So let's start. Question first, find my match. In this A group, lotus, aloe, cuscuta, Venus flytrap. And in the B group, flowers and leaves attract insects, hysterical roots for absorption of food, adapted to live in deserts, adapted to live in water. So first match, lotus, adapted to live in water, aloe, adapted to live in deserts, cuscuta, hysterical roots for absorption of food, Venus flytrap, flower and leaves attract insects. Next question. Read the paragraph and answer the following questions. I am a penguin. I live in polar region, covered by snow. My abdomen is white. My skin is thick with a layer of fat underneath. My body is spindle shaped. My wings are small. My toes are webbed. We live in flocks. So, first question. Why is my skin white and thick? And why is there a thick layer of fat underneath? And answer is, having black and white skin is a type of adaptation. It is harder for both the predators and the prey to see penguins from all sorts of angles. Thick layer of fat keeps them warm under such extreme cold condition. So this is the answer of first question. Now next question. Why do we live in flocks, sticking close to each other? And the answer is, we know that penguins live in the coldest region. We live together to keep each other warm. So this is why they live in flocks, sticking close to each other. Next question. Which geographical region do I inhabit? Why? Answer. Penguins are found in regions of Africa, South America, New Zealand, and the sub-Antarctic island because climatic conditions are suitable for penguins. Next question. Which adaptations should you have to enable you to live permanently in the polar region? Why? Answer. The following adaptations are required to survive in polar region. First, black and white skin with a thick layer of fat. Second, skin should be covered with feathers. Third, small body with small wings. Here, the word you is not needed here. Next question. Who is lying? Question number 3. Who is lying? In this question, sub question first. A. Cockroach says, I have 5 legs. And the answer is, the cockroach is lying because it has 6 legs and not 5. Next, hen says, my toes are webbed. And the answer is, the hen is lying because hen do not sail on water, so that she can't have webbed feet. Next, cactus says, my fleshy green part is a leaf. And answer is, The cactus is also lying because its fleshy green part is a stem and not a leaf. Next, question number 4. Read each of the following statements. Write a paragraph about adaptation with reference to each statement. First, A. There is extreme heat in desert. Answer. The animals and plants which are found in this region have special modification which help them to survive in such environment. They have special photosynthetic pathway in which stomata remains closed during daytime. Desert animals have adaptive features like thick skin to prevent the loss of water, long legs with flat and cushioned soles, long and thick eyelashes, and nostrils which are protected by folds of skin of animal like camel. Next question. Grasslands are lush green. Answer. Grasslands are lush green due to the presence of diverse types of bush grasses. Grasses are tall so that animals like tiger, lion, elephant can remain hidden in them. Animals which are found in grassland region have adaptation like strong legs to run fast. Next question. Insects are found in large numbers. Answer. Insects are found in large numbers because they have developed a mechanism which help them to survive even harshest of environment. Next question. We hide. Answer. Some species which are able to hide themselves by blending their color with that of the surroundings. This adaptive mechanism helps to protect them from the predators and prey. That is why we hide. Next question. We have long ears. This adaptive mechanism helps them to receive sound from the long distances and from different directions. Because of that, we have long ears. Question number 5. Answer the following. A. Why is the camel called the sheep of the desert? Answer. Camel is the only animal can transport material in desert. The body of camel has undergone modifications that helps to survive in the hot and dry conditions. Camel can survive without food for several days in desert. Camel can also survive without water for several days in desert, and that is why the camel is called sheep of the desert. Next question. How can the plant like cactus and acacia live in deserts with scarce water? Answer. Stomata of these plants remain closed during daytime. Their leaves are reduced to spines to minimize water loss. And in this way, cactus and acacia live in deserts with scarce water. Next question. What is the interrelationship between adaptations and organisms and their surroundings? Answer. Adaptation means the modification or change in the organism's body or behavior that helps to survive in a particular environment. These factors can be in the form of climate, the kinds of food plants that grow in it. Camel have long legs which prevent him from heat and sand. Plant in a snowy region have conical in shape and hence they did not accumulating snow on their leaves. So this is the interrelationship between adaptations of organisms and their surroundings. Next question, how are organisms classified? The hierarchy of classification was developed by Carolus Linnaeus. According to Carolus Linnaeus, kingdom is the highest rank. It is divided into phylum or division, which are further subdivided into classes for the divisions, include order, family, genus and species in that order. So, according to Carolus Linnaeus, the classification is as follows: kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus and species. So that's all about the first exercise of first lesson.